I've always loved fashion. I was one of those little girls that absolutely was into trends and colors, but also happened to be really good at math and science. And luckily, no one told me that I couldn't do those two things together. I come from tech. I'm a scientist and a technologist. And working with large technology companies like Intel or Google, they all have a lot of internal R&D, and they're designing the future of their own industry. When I moved into the fashion industry, I was surprised to find that wasn't happening inside of big brands. I'm very worried about the long-term effects of microfibers and what we don't even know about what's out there long-term. It's like one of those terrifying things to consider as a scientist. Traditional synthetics, when they're washed, the surface of the textile, you'll see kind of little hairs that start to stick up. Those are the pieces of the fiber that start to break off and create the tiny microfibers. It's a design problem. PANGAIA is a material science brand who kind of manifests publicly as a fashion brand. We are looking for across-the-board solutions around the future of sustainability for fashion. PANGAIA has come together with MTIX for the Microfiber Innovation Challenge, and MTIX is an amazing technology company that has created something called MLSE, Multiplex Laser Surface Enhancement, that basically mixes plasma, gas, and laser to be able to create a change in the surface finish of a textile, create a much smoother surface that is like sealed, where the fibers themselves all stick together and do not tend to break off in the same way during washing. It just took us a while to understand the depth and breadth of what was possible. The first step of the process is to do an analysis of the fabric itself, which you do with a scanning electron microscope, to understand the quality of the fabric and the composition. And then from there, that outputs data which feeds into the algorithm. Based on what the surface is made of and the quality of the surface, then there's a customized algorithm which goes on top to then treat that. We were so enthralled by this idea that there was a solution that could apply to many different textile treatments that we were looking to solve without chemistry, that there could be a singular solution, a singular system. It can be inside of any textile production factory and could be just the last step of finishing. The solution that we're working on actively is one that kind of meets the industry where it's at. We're going to take the fashion industry by storm with this technology, because once it's doing all of these things that are done in different places with different chemistries and all different cycles, we can do it all in one place. That's going to be a major breakthrough that I think they're going to be a little bit shocked. There's not as much emphasis put on innovation and technology inside of fashion. There's very much a focus on craft and aesthetics, as I think there should be. But, you know, we wanted to show that there's a way that we can have these two things work together, that they're not at odds with each other, and that the fashion industry can move forward progressively without losing so much of the things we love about it.